Keith Schilling started with that problem. He had Robin, then Usman. He takes on Chris Lencioni on the main pound of Bellator 232 this Saturday at the Mohegan Sun Event Center. How you doing, man?
I'm good. I'm excited. I can't wait for Saturday.
Obviously, you've been fighting in MMA. You got two fights in your belt, but you're known for your kickboxing. You're a multi-time world champion.
That's
you know, why the transition to MMA?
Kickboxing, you know, didn't excite me anymore. I beat everybody in the lightweight and the featherweight, so just time to move on, you know, get a new excitement, new motivation. So I found an MMA.
What excites you about MMA?
I started at the bottom, so that's what excites me. I started at the bottom. I have to build myself up again. You know, I want to be a champion in this too. The same thing I did in kickboxing. I want to be a two-division world champion. So that's what brought me in.
Obviously, you have lofty goals, but striking and kickboxing is different than striking, man. What has been the hardest transition going from a kickboxing background to an MMA? What have you had to learn? What have you had to unlearn?
I think the hardest transition was that it's a whole different game. It's a new game. It's totally different than a kickboxing, even the stand-up. But I feel more comfortable with MMA gloves to stand-up than with the kickboxing. So for me, it's perfect.
So have you watched any film on Chris? And if you have, what do you think about it? And how do you feel you match up?
No, I never watch up videos of my opponent just because I want to be me. I want to do me. I do everything on intuition, feeling. I let my training partners, coaches watch and they give me details what to adjust and whatnot. So I think we did a great training camp. I can't wait for Saturday to prove it.
Did you do the same thing in kickboxing? Did you not watch film?
Yeah, we did the same thing in kickboxing. We never watched film. We always went out from our own strength and build up from there.
Is that a mental thing? Like, is it to not psych yourself out or not to focus like, oh, he's got a good right hand?
Yeah.
And you keep focusing on the right hand,
exactly.
And now you get hit with the left hook.
That's what I mean. For me, it's like more focusing on myself. And if I think too much he's good at that, I'm going to think too much about that. Oh, I have to figure out that and that. But there's so many things in MMA you have to worry about. So I just want to focus on everything, just the total package.
Obviously, the guys here at Bellator are very excited about you. You get the promotional push. You're on the main card, a double event. How far until you know, I know disrespect to your opponent, but you're going against a big name, against a AJ McKee, against a Pitbull, one of these guys. Like, how far away do you think you are?
I don't know, to be honest. I'm not thinking about that right now. I'm thinking about this Saturday, beating this guy first, and from there, we look up. If Bellator wants to bring me in them guys, I'm cool with that. If not, I wait. For me, it's easy. I just want to fight. I want to show my skills and build up from there.
I seen both of your fights. You won. Knocked out both guys in brutal fashion. One guy was his leg. You just kicked his legs out,
yeah.
And he couldn't stand up. The other guy you knocked out in brutal fashion. Is there any way this guy stands up with you, or you expect him trying to go right for a takedown?
I expect he to go for the takedown right away, but it's not going to be that easy to take me down. I've been training with high-level wrestlers, grapplers, so, you know, this MMA. And if he wants to take me down, he's going to eat something in between, so we will see. I don't care. If you want to stand up, we stand up. If you want to grapple, we grapple. Simple.
What's the chances he takes you down and you get a submission on the ground?
If you go on the ground, I probably not submit him. I probably ground him, pound him, and make him feel so. I don't care. For me, like, it's good. If I get a submission, I get it. If I get a ground pound, if I get a knockout, it's whatever I get.
All right, so obviously the kickboxing world knows you. Not a lot of MMA people, if they don't follow kickboxing, won't know you. After your performance on Saturday, what is the MMA community going to be saying about you?
What took him so long to bring it? What took him so long? He finally is, so that's what they're going to say after this performance.
Good luck to you, sir.
Thank you.